exciting, and this is just that warm-up. The warm-up is one of the most important things when we work our core. Again, our core is going to strengthen our overall strength. It's going to help with our balance. It'll help with back pain. So again, we're just lightly turning here from side to side, and we're going to go 5, 4, just work on that range of motion, 3, and 2, we got one more over here. Now I want you to just kind of drop your bodies, and we're going to go into a nice swim here. So we're going all the way around and around, and we're loosening up, we're twisting at our torso here. Again, that's very important as we warm up our core. It's great for our back, so we're going to swim around here for 3, 2, and 1, and let's go the other direction here to really loosen it up. Again, we're just swimming those arms around and around, sitting up nice and straight. We'll go 3, 2, 1, and now let's just kind of crisscross those arms. It's always a great thing to loosen up our upper neck, our upper back muscles here, and we're going to go 3, 2, and 1, and of course we're going to march those legs again, getting that heart rate going. Let's go 10, 9, 8, and 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and run it out with those feet. We'll go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and excellent job with that. Now bring your arms right up to here. We're going to bring the same elbow down to the same knee. So we're going like this and down. Again, I want you to look down on your opposite knee. So look down and tap. Again, look down and tap. Again, you'll feel this in your side obliques. It's one of the most important things as far as strengthening that upper and lower back here. So we're going to go 5, 4, 3, make sure you're breathing, and 2, excellent work, 1, keep those arms up, same thing, other sides, we're looking down at that other knee and lifting and touching that elbow, again, feeling that squeeze right in that side oblique, those side abdominals here. Again, don't forget to breathe, sit up straight, we're going to go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's march those legs. We'll go 3, 2, 1, and excellent job with that. Now, I want you to tricycle's opposite legs here to opposite elbows. So we're going this way and that way. Again, nice and slow here as we start slow and controlled. We're going to go 10. Some calories. and stand on up. We're going to do that two more times. So mini squat down. Bring your arms right on up. Squeeze your core for three. Two, squeeze those abs. One, bring it down. Stand up nice and tall. One more time. Mini squat down. Arms are straight out in that angle. Squeeze your abs for three. Two. One. Excellent job. We got one more standing thing. We're going to bring our arms all the way over our head here. So bring them all the way up, just like this. We're going to go this way and that way. Again, we're going to have nice wide legs here so we can go through this range of motion. And we're going to go 10. This is like a stretch. 9. Very important to stretch out these abs. And 7. 6, don't forget to breathe. 5, 4, good work. 3, 2, last 1, and now let's just crisscross those arms. We're going to start to stretch. Now, when it comes to the core, stretching is the most important thing. Now, when we're doing those crunches, I know it burns, but we have to stretch out our muscles. We have to stretch those hamstrings, those glutes, and all those abdominal muscles that we work. So we're just going to start right here. We're going to go 3, 2, 1, and now we're going to go into that swim where we rotate our hips and bring it to a front crawl, or curl around and around for 3, 2, 1, and back crawl again around and around, and we'll go 3, 2, 1, and excellent job. Kind of rub those abs a little bit, but bring those arms right out here. Close your fists. We're going to go from side to side. We're going to go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Kind of tighten those abs. 4, 3, 2, 1. And excellent job. Now we got to lean into this chair. We're going to bring this leg forward. You have to push that back heel down. Push that knee in. Push into your chair and feel that stretch on the back part of your calf. And we're going to go 3, 2, 1, excellent job. Now straighten this leg just like this. We're gonna push downward again. You're gonna feel it right through here. Push that heel into the ground. You can slightly reach down. Again, we're stretching our hamstrings. Typically, when our hamstrings are tight, it causes pressure on our back. So loosen it up here. And we'll go 3, 2, good work, and 1. Let's just nice and slowly stand up. Let's switch our feet around. We're pushing this knee in. That back heel is down. Push into your chair. Feel that stretch on that back calf. And again, like I said, anytime our muscles are tight, it tends to hurt in our back. So we're going to stretch those out here. We'll go 3, 2, 1, and straighten that front leg. Push that heel into the ground. Feel the stretch behind that hamstring and reach your hand on down. And you keep this leg straight. Feel the stretch behind that leg, and we'll go 3, 2, 1, and excellent job. Now we're going to just bring our feet back like this. We're going to push our hips back. We're going to sink our shoulders, looking right down at the ground. Straighten those arms, feel this behind your legs, through your back, and we'll go 3, 2, 1, and again, excellent job. Now I want you to come just like this. We're going to keep both feet together. Use your chair if you have to, and we're just going to reach right on down. You don't need that chair, just kind of wiggle those fingers here. We're going to go 3, 2, 1, and standing up nice and slow. Now I want you to grab onto those hips. Let's just roll them out here. And these hips also get tight. Cause some pain in our back. Cause weakness through our abs. So we're going to loosen them up here. Let's go 3, 2, 1, other direction. We're going to round and around, and we'll go 3, 2, 1, and again, excellent job with that first core routine. Now, after this one, again, you should be mixing, matching these workouts in with other things.